This work described the upscaling of the nanofermentation process to make really large pilot scale production of nanoparticles, particularly the zinc sulfides. And this kind of a reactor here demonstrates the pinnacle of years of work of Jiwan and some of our other collaborators to be able to manufacture these things in quantities that are relevant for testing. And in smaller scale reactors to begin to develop processes that are using as few valuable chemicals as possible to develop the greenest possible chemistry.
We use bacteria, so there is no toxic reducing agent or organic sorbent. So it is an environmental friendly green process. And also it is close to room temperature, 65 degrees Celsius, compared to the 200 to 400 degrees Celsius chemical synthesis. So we can save a lot of energy. This zinc sulfide can be used for one of the semiconducting materials. So it can be applied to the light emitting material device, and also one component of a photovoltaic cell that is a solar cell panel. Usually the good, efficient solar cell panel is composed of one buffer layer and one absorbing layer. And well-known buffer layer is cadmium sulfide, but nobody wants to use the toxic cadmium on their roof. So we can replace the zinc sulfide instead of cadmium sulfide.
The volume of these things relative to their surface area becomes really small, and they start to exhibit quantum effects in there. And so we're able to get completely different properties, very non-linear transformations as we get to quantum dot size materials that give completely different optical properties, completely different electronic properties, and really change the value proposition of this work.